NerdDice.
Hello and welcome to this stateless Codecast. Happy New Year, at least I'm assuming it's Happy New Year. It's December 29th, 2020 as I'm recording this, so this is scheduled to drop on New Year's Day 2021, but it could be December 32nd, 2020. Zuckerberg could have declared himself emperor. It could be Zuckerberg first, the year one, who knows. But assuming that it's January 1st, 2021, Happy New Year, we've got a little bit of branding we're going to apply to our NerdDice repo before we get started on coding. So go to settings here, and there is a section for social preview. So I'm gonna click upload an image here. And let me pause while I get my image. So because of the GitHub recommendations, we're going to pick the 1280 by 640 logo here. And now we've got a social preview for our gem. So in terms of coding today, I'm also going to, we're going to continue working on this, allowing configuration to happen. In this particular case, we're going to be working on ability to reset the seed on your random interval here. And if you recall, we'll go to our branch that we're working on, apply config. We change some of the items here. So we've got this refresh seed interval item in our config now, and we're going to try to apply that in our code today. Also, you can see here, Ruby 3.0 has dropped. So if we go you can see here in the console, it's running 3.0.0. And our specs are all still passing. So we're going to now go in here and do a little bit of housekeeping. The first of all, one of the changes of Ruby 3 is that securerandom is now a bundled gem instead of part of the standard library. At least I thought it was. Because there's no underscore. So this is the version we have of this. It looks like it hasn't changed in a long, long time. So we're going to add that as a development dependency in our gem spec here. Thank you. sure we get the right one here. So I think this is the one that we want here. So we're still working here. All right. So now the next thing we're going to do, so we've got some methods here that are def self.configure, def self.configuration, and then we have this class self section. So we're going to just take these add to those. Still passing. And then I think we were premature in making execute die roll a private method. So I'm going to promote this and make it a public method, which means it should have some specs associated with it. And all three of these methods should have commenting for them. So we're going to do that now. And we'll actually probably just make this the entirety of the video, and then in our next video we'll work on the resetting the seed. So I'm gonna pause for a second and add in some comments for our methods here. So we've got our method comments written here. One thing that I want to test, let me save this, run my specs. I want to see what the configuration value returns. Steal this from our spec here. So you can see it's just returning the last value of the last line in that block. So we're going to change that behavior. This is going to fail. All expected the configuration item, and we got the last value in the block. So go back here to NerdDice. Explicitly return configuration here. And we're back to passing. Now we need tests for this execute role, die roll method. Use the same model that we did for total dice here. So the name of our shared example. So this is going to fail, saying that the shared example doesn't exist. Now we need, oh dear, we need to save as here. Total dice, we need to git reset on that. I think all is right with the world. We'll do this early this time. Rid of this. And in this case, we only need context. We'll make this just pick one. Twenties here just to be different. Alright. So that is working. Now we need is the name of that argument. And we'll change all of these to that value. Implemented. Let's go back and implement an empty block. We'll call this raise the error here. It should be how did we do this in configuration? Just need to namespace it. See if that still works. All right. There we go. So that's working now. We will looks like we've made RuboCop angry. Let's uh see here. So it might be time to upgrade RuboCop, but all right, so let's go back to our item here. Make them separate expectations. Never took the old one out. Let's try it again. Yep, that's right. Fences. All right, so let's get ready for our commit message here. We're going to also add our some of the brand assets here. We'll make another drag. Got those all added. In the right place. RoboCop's still happy, and we'll looking good. We're gonna configure Code VS Code as our code editor here. So you can see it comes up. There's a nice little handy line that lets you do that. Although I'm gonna have to redo it after because I forgot to sign the commit. So, but anyway, I'll write my commit message. So we've got our commit message here. Good, except the fact that's not signed. I'll pause and sign it. Push it to the remote and that's it. See you next video. Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.